Benvenuti al podcast Simulazione. Il mio nome è Jan e sono unito da una splendida Fallon.
Hi.
E il quasi italiano Pablo.
Thank you. Hi everybody.
I try to listen so intently for my name, but it surprises me.
Anyway, like, it was quite short. I think the French one last week was a bit longer, even though I said the exact same thing.
Maybe you said it faster this time.
It is with Italian. With Italian, you have to speak fast, because otherwise you cannot pronounce the words correctly.
you're doing just fine. This week, actually, we have a bunch of news, luckily. Because, you know, the City Skylines Dev Diaries come right after we do our podcast. So last week's, you got it on this episode. And also, you got just about nothing about The Sims 4. But, of course, Fallon's always got you covered with 5 weekly mods for The Sims 4. So you're going to have that later on.
One thing.
She can actually think one. We are going to have The Sims 4 news.
Just one thing.
Oh, nice. Oh, we're definitely going to do that then. First off, we're going to kick it off with City Skylines, because the Dev Diary 5 Outside Connections was released last week, and Jan is going to cover it for you.
Yeah, and it was. We actually posted it on our website, which now has a City Skylines little section, and we post everything because it's lovingly formatted and it looks lovely. This week's Dev Diary was about Outside Connections. Basically, they improved on the transport Dev Diary from 2 weeks ago and just told us a bit more about transport. Basically,
although
what they said
I like to add that this sort of like shows you a little bit how the economic system works, especially with the import, export, and the tourism part, you know? Like that.
Well, basically what they said is that Yoda is coming to visit on the tourist ship. And what they said is they basically outlined that tourists always arrive to your city, but the quantity is determined by how high your land value is and if you have monuments or wonders or whatever. And that's what determines the amount of tourists. And the most tourists arrive by apparently train and harbor. And the most traffic cargo also arrives by train and harbor. How it works is your industry first, when it produces its goods, first tries to sell them to the local shops. If the shops are full, then they ship it to the outside world. That's why in your starting plot, you will always have a highway connection. Because it will ship it by highway if there are no other options. If you have other options, it will go via other options first, I guess.
Right.
With tourism, well, we got
trains.
An example of how you get kind of like monuments. Here's one that, for example, when your city produces 1,000 units of goods, you get the stadium of many things.
Of many things. I like the generic name on that.
You should keep that name. Stadium of many things.
For
example,
this stadium improves happiness of citizens around it and your general happiness. Your citizens go to it, as well as it drives in more tourists to your city. And they come to see sites and shops. It's important if you get them in with public transport that you then have a good public transport network in your town. Even if they come by their own car via the highway, it's important to have a good public transport system. Otherwise, it can clog up your roads.
Right.
What else did they say? They talked about monuments. Now, monuments they are doing in a slightly different way than SimCity used to do them. Because with SimCity, you had landmarks that you would unlock like you unlock monuments here. But here, you have a strange thing where monuments are grouped into 5 sort of... I think they're calling them skill trees, or
they look like the skill trees. Yeah.
Skill trees.
Basically, once you unlock, I don't know how many. Once you finish the skill tree, you get a wonder.
Mm-hmm.
And it says that the wonders are massive buildings that basically remove one need from the city. And that's all we know about the wonders. They did say they were going to talk about them in a further dev diary, so.
Right.
Good, I guess.
The UI has been redone.
The UI has been redone, yes. It's not good yet. it could still do with some improvement. It's definitely better than what it was before.
Yeah, I see some nice changes.
But I still prefer Pablo's UI, so everyone go on the forums of Paradox and tell them to just goddamn hire Pablo. Just license his UI or something and make us money.
Wait, the person who brought this is not the UI designer, is it? Oh, no, lead designer of Cities Skylines. Okay. I wouldn't like to take somebody's job ever.
Carolina Corpo. Corpo?
They'll just pay you with food, remember? They won't, like,
yeah, I mean, one. I would take food, Paradox, if you want. I mean, you know, what aspirates we can get in Argentina. Just send a, yeah, send chocolate. Send a, ooh,
what,
yeah.
Chocolate?
But,
Send some Milka or Kinder Surprises.
Wait, is Carolina the quote-unquote Polish girl, or... I'm just making that up.
This is just the lead designer. I can't remember what the...
That wasn't the... Oh, no, she was like something engineer. That was her title, something. I remember. Yeah.
Anyway. Lead engineer or something of that sort. But yeah, that's what we had for City Skylines. I mean...
Yeah, although I do like how this sort of like... I know I'm sort of like showing pictures and text at the same time on the screen, but oh well. But, you know, I kind of like the... Yeah, the monuments are grouped into 5 skill trees, you know, pathways to getting the ultimate building's wonders. So basically the wonders are like the last monument you get. They're called wonders because they do fancy things differently. And they basically like, I don't know if you just said it, but basically it removes a need of your city or the need of providing that, right?
Yeah. I'm guessing these wonders are something like an ultimate wonder that provides ultimate electricity or ultimate water or...
I'm assuming you can only get one, maybe two at most.
Ultimate water.
Infinite water source or something.
Infinite
I don't
water.
Know. It wasn't really explained, but they said they're going to do it in another dev diary, so...
Yeah.
Maybe next week, maybe in a few weeks, we'll see. Well, not next week, in 2 weeks.
But this is looking tight. I do like it. It feels like... They got this under control.
It's looking better and better. And I do like the way the Expo Center looks as well. I don't know if you've shown it, but it looks quite nice. It looks more like an Expo Center than whatever they could ever put in The Sims. Well, in SimCity.
In SimCity, oh yeah. I actually... I had a picture right here, but I don't know where it is right now. But yeah, the Expo Center was like the circular thing. Yeah, this looks kind of nice. It's actually the thumbnail for our article in the SimNation. So yeah, definitely I like where this is going.
Alrighty. Looking very nice so far. And with the 5th dev diary, I haven't really noticed anything that I could say looks bad so far other than the UI, but the UI has been slightly improved now, so I'm hoping they're going to continue working on it.
Yeah, they got 6 months.
Yeah, but other than that, it looks good so far. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, definitely. All right. So that is pretty much it for City Skylines. Quick update on SimCity, I guess. SimCity Build It is out, and I was not able to try it. I think, Jan, either. It's not in your country either, right? They're making, like, a very strange rollout for SimCity.
The only one that's available on so far is the New Zealand store, from what I can see.
Yeah, in New Zealand. It's not in the U.S.?
I don't think so.
I think not. That's
need
the,
your
yay.
Things to connect to certain countries and then buy it?
No, I not
can.
The App Store.
I can work on it now.
But it it's actually tied to your credit card.
Sims 4.
No, I don't think that's possible. But yeah, I don't know. SimCity Builder is basically, you know, you build like some kind of like resource chain and you tap once in a while to I don't know. The only thing that looked nice is like you saw all the little cars actually going through traffic and like stopping at the red lights. That was the fanciest thing, like a beautiful animation to just watch on your phone.
Maybe that's where all their budget went to.
Yeah. Oh, but
yeah,
I saw
me it's only available in the New Zealand store still, so go to New Zealand and get it.
Right.
I wouldn't.
Oh, wait, actually, wait, hold on. On our forum, somebody said, and let me open the trailer. Yeah, somebody said in our forum, this is the article, right? But there are like replies on the bottom, and somebody said, I'm trying the game on my phone, said Colstar. So basically, yeah, I'm guessing that it is on the US.
But let me switch to the US store and see if it's there.
He said, I don't know why his name is not showing up here, but he said, I'm trying the game on my phone. So far, it looks quite pretty. It has much the similar gameplay to Citadel. Still, it probably have even less soul. At least Citadel has some really nice cartoon designs. This seems a bit soulless. I guess at least you don't need to, friends to play the game, only money. Which I agree. At least you don't have to like bother people. Like, I want to play this game. Join it. Like, no, play your own game, you know?
Yeah.
I hate those social games that do that, you know?
That's why you just play them on Facebook and then you just specifically add people that play that game. I need to delete all those people that I added to my Facebook to play a game because they're not like really my friends or anything.
Yeah.
Go to the community page. Add me. I play this game. Add me. I play this game. Add me. I play this game.
Just die.
I hate that.
If you do that, you can die.
No, they're asking you to add them specifically because they play the game. They're not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. A pig escaped from my farm. You know what? You know what I'm going to do with your pig? I'm going to cook it.
You need a
friend. And I'm
going to
show you pictures of
your
pig while I'm eating it. Oh, yes.
That
anyways.
Reminds me of something
so,
else.
We have the Sims stuff, right?
Sims what?
Wait, you said there were some Sims news.
Oh, I said there was one thing. There's
that's
one
all I
thing.
Need.
Okay. Before people, I had noticed people were saying like it would be super awesome if there was another way to access the gallery from outside of the game. And actually now on the Sims website, there is. You can go see everything that's in the gallery. On the Sims.com website, there's a section at the top where you'd hit community, then you scroll down to gallery, and you can elect to have things queued up to download when you get into your game. So like if you're like, oh, that's really cool, but I'm not at home right now or whatever, and then you download it. So then when you go, if you sign in with your Origin account. Sign in with your Origin account to the website and then click it and then it'll have it queued up. So when you are playing your game, it'll start downloading it for you.
Right, so, I see. No, but that is cool that you can do this. Yeah. Especially because, yeah, we could eventually start talking about stuff like this.
Yeah, I don't think they would have done it otherwise, except for the fact that a lot of people had said, you know, can you make something where we don't have to be in the game to see the gallery?
Yeah. No, that's actually pretty nice. I agree. So thesims.com, and then you just go to community and the gallery. I actually showed it on the screen. Yeah.
Or you can just straight up type in thesims.com/gallery.
Oh, slash gallery. Okay. That is good.
Yeah. They cool. Like the trending, the browse, Max's top downloads and stuff, so you can see everything. If you weren't already obsessed with the gallery before, you could be
now you can stop working.
Now you can stalk people without the game. But yeah.
I can confirm SimCity Build It is not on the US store.
It's not?
No.
Oh, man. I wish Fountain had an iPhone.
I was
right
saying,
now.
Like, if you use the VPN on your phone, if you could, like, go connect to, like, New Zealand IP address or whatever.
But the App Store uses your credit card.
That's silly because you could go to a foreign country and have your US credit card, so.
Oh, yeah, you need to change the credit card.
Well, I just have two accounts. One is the.
I see. So it's weird. We need to ask that guy how he got it.
Huh. It might be available on the...
maybe it's Canada or something like that.
Could you use PayPal? Because maybe then if you use PayPal, you could be like, whatever.
I just won't take PayPal. Oh, actually,
well,
I think you can in the US.
iPhone.
Yeah. But, anyways. I think that's pretty much it. We went through the news fairly quickly, but that was nice, compact. It only took us like 15 minutes, so I'm proud. But I guess right now we have the last piece of structured content, which is the Sims 4 mods, right?
Oh, yeah. Structured content. Because
then it's just talking about nothing.
That, again, no one wants to release any early info. It's like beating a pinata. You have to like beat it like 20 times before it breaks.
What thing?
do you know a pinata?
That yeah, but what are you talking about?
Oh, yes. Like getting news from EA, getting any kind of news.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Who's going to blame you? No one knows what's going on.
It's just like, I mean, maybe if I were famous, then like it would matter, but no.
Also, I just thought maybe the guy has an Android. I think it's available on the Android App Store.
Okay, let me look. What is it called? Stupid Build
It.
It
could be a thing.
SimCity Build It.
Oh, look, I translated it to Japanese for me, but I can't even. SimCity Building.
We're in the Sims 4 file mods, but we're taking that out.
Yeah.
No, it's funny because now we have the text on the bottom that is totally spoiling like any kind of offset activity.
Yeah, I don't think I'd have to look for it. Are these in order still? Who knows? So the first one is supposed to be mods, dance, Pablo. Mods. Yeah, dance, yeah. Oh. He's like the Grinch in the movie. You're like Jim Carrey as a green man. The first one is not from Mod the Sims. Although Mod the Sims is really awesome and they do have tons. I think people just like using that the most. This is from the Sims resource. It's just Bible ponds. So like if you want to have your own fishing pond, like in the back of your house, nice. It cloned the ponds from the game and then put them in the objects so that you can buy them. And there's different, there's six total different variations of the ponds you can get, like depending on if they're common or uncommon or rare. And then
basically you can fish for those kind of fishes there, right? They automatically
fish
come with fishes.
Or frogs. Yeah, some ponds, right, you know, they give you the... So that way you can have like... And the ponds look nice too, like as for decorated
yeah,
purposes.
Some do.
So like if you wanted to have that cool, like, I don't know, Modi style house castle with some ponds.
Yeah.
And then you can happen to get some frogs out of those ponds. It's all good. Best of both.
True.
I could not find it on my Play Store, so I have to look later.
Oh, okay.
So this is on the Sims resource. And the Sims resource is also really good for, like, CC. I used to use it all the time for the Sims 3 to download Hair. Although Sims 4 Hair, you really have to give me an excellent Hair CC because it's got to fit the Sims 4 style. Otherwise, it will be creepy.
Yeah, I totally agree on that.
I mean, some people do have hair out, but it's that more like realistic Sims 3 kind of.
It's gonna look out of place, like for what that person? Yeah,
with the individual like hair follicles.
He has to look cartoonish, Disney-ish. Yeah. Anyways, yeah. Just, please.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. So that's the first one. I think these are still in order. I don't remember. The second one is liposuction. Is it? It is. Okay. So if you were, it's a funny. They just make the funniest mod sometimes. This is basically, you know how
the names they pick for them.
Yeah. It's lipoaspiration and body implants. So they have the rewards, right? Where if you buy the get thin or get bigger, the potions. But this is a feature you can buy from your phone to make you skinnier or to make you more. The body implants is more muscular. It's not boobs. Okay.
That is weird. Actually, that is super creepy. You're putting implants as muscles. That is so creepy. Personal magic trainer or something?
Or like bodybuilder. It's muscles or skinniness.
right.
But it's a service you buy through your phone. Now it will conflict if you already have downloaded stuff that has that changes the phone. So it isn't in the instructions. You just have to kind of download like one extra thing to make them both work. And then your sim buys the lipoaspiration or the body implants. Some people were saying, hey, you should add a boob one.
But how do you measure it?
Like, I don't know.
How do you make it bigger? How big?
Maybe if you keep buying it, it'll keep making them bigger.
Right? It just stacks.
Yeah, I just thought this was so funny, though, because...
And if you don't want them anymore, you turn them into mouse pads. They're made of the same thing.
Oh. Okay. I need to calm down. That's ridiculous.
Welcome to the Zen Nation podcast.
Yeah, well, we're talking about mouse pad boobies. All right.
There are some.
Yeah, but no. So some people, yeah, were saying it'd be cool if you could add like the boob feature because they were confused that body implants didn't mean boobs, it meant muscles. But why people are even making this in the first place is just astounding. I guess they didn't want to waste aspiration points on buying the potions. So, you know, actually the potion only makes you fat or skinny. It doesn't give you muscles. It makes you fat or skinny. Okay.
Fat or skinny.
Right. So this gives you muscles or skinniness. Okay, next.
Okay, guys, do you think I can show this or not? Because I googled boob mouse pad and I got results. They're not that bad.
Oh, are they the mouse pads like with the bumps on them?
Yeah,
like,
whatever. I'll do it.
Pills.
So here it is, guys. It's this is, see, you can just, you don't want it anymore, they're too expensive for you, just make one of these. I mean, they come in anime shape, they come in whatever this celebrity is.
I think those are
look at this, this is not a boob, it's her behind, but that works as well, pretty much. So, like, you know, that. Anyways, yes, back to the PG-13.
I think those would be most uncomfortable on your hand, though.
Yeah, right? Especially because there's like a middle area, like a valley in the middle. You get stuck at, you know?
Put your hand in the boob valley and you'll be okay.
I did not sign up for this.
Blame Pablo. Okay, but no, the ones with the anime butts and their legs, that is really perverted. I'm sorry. Why did you even... Pablo, don't do this.
Just move on.
I think the next one, okay, is the daily save mod. I think that's the next one. They might have, okay, I didn't want them to get out of order. Basically, so because normally your Sims game only autosaves when you leave your lot. When you transition between lots. So this mod has nothing to do with boobs. And it basically lets you set up like a time frame for when your game will auto save itself so that you don't have to worry about it. You could have it save every hour if you wanted to. But I think you end up with a crap ton of save.
Sorry, I'm still laughing.
Stop.
About the boob
valley. You pervert. Stop thinking about boob.
The boob valley was hilarious.
Next week, Pablo should have bought one, and then he'll have it like on his chest, so that way when we introduce ourselves,
I have my hand stuck in there.
It'll be it'll be mouse pad boob.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. I'm sure all the guys are enjoying their Google searching of the.
So this will basically save for you.
Yes, you set up in the console the timer or whatever, and it'll save for you at a certain interval automatically.
Right.
You're not allowed to talk about anything anymore, Pablo.
Oh, man. Next one, please.
Okay, this next one is the longer emotion potions. Basically, like, it increases the length. So maybe you didn't like the fact that your sim potions only lasted for 4 hours or something, and you were using them, like, before you went to work. And then you're like, oops, I used it too early. So there's different versions you can download. Some only increase it a little bit, like 6 hours. Some increase it for 12 hours if you take one potion. Like, it'll be like 8 hours. If you take another potion, it'll be 12 hours. And all the way up to 24 hours, which is like the super dose. So just it gives people options if you want to, you know, extend the
way the game works. Yeah.
Extend the length of the potions. I think they still cost the same, which is nice.
Makes sense.
You're going to have a 24-hour flirty mood.
Oh, man. Like, shut up. Shut up, Arena, for another 12 hours. Now you come here.
I wonder, though, if your Sims will be more inclined to die if they have this 24-hour mood going on.
I don't think so. You think?
Because you'll get, like, super... I mean, you know, you'll have your regular mood, and then you'll get very... And then you'll get, like, so extra that you die.
I don't think that's
can
in the game.
Can you be so flirty that you die? No, you can be so...
There's no
you can be,
death out of flirtiness.
You can be so playful that you die. You laugh yourself to death.
Yeah. That can happen.
No, so use the potions at your Sim's risk.
Yes.
Stacking. How many potions can I stack before my Sim laughs themselves to death?
Which is a super common thing, like the top 5th reason why people die in America. Yeah, you have to watch out when you watch funny videos.
It's why they died in Who Framed Roger Rabbit. Don't laugh, because you'll laugh yourself to death.
Yeah, everybody knows that. Heart attack? Not an issue.
Only
that,
if you're... No.
I'm watching you, comedians.
Only if it was a cartoon. Only if you're...
Comedians, you're killing it! Yeah, anyways, I'm done with the puns. Go ahead.
Okay, the last one is, still not related to boobs. It's, we did that boob one long time ago. It's just...
She has boobs.
Lights. Got the female Sim in the picture. It makes your indoor lights brighter. There's two different ones, but I see in the comments that this one... That people like this one a little bit more. It increases their brightness, and some things, like where the colors of your furniture weren't turning out right, it helps to, like, with the brightness correct. Like, some people were saying their furniture looked green when it was supposed to look blue because the lights weren't, you know, really bright.
So basically, adjusts it or balances it, right? That UI has always been there, right? The color and dimmer thingy?
Yeah, the color.
I never tried that out. Wow, that is cool.
Always been there for the lights that allow you to have colors, but you can still adjust it yourself, but it still, like, boosts the brightness of the mod. So, like, you can see in the picture, the original version, the Sim is very dark right underneath of the light, and then with the mod, the Sim is, like, really bright, or, you know, you can see the Sim details.
Yeah, it's super clear, yeah.
With the lights. Yeah, so just some people, you know, say, like, the game lights don't get as bright as they used to be able to get, like in Sims 3. And Sims 3 lights were really nice, but so this one, you can still change the dimmer, but the just
that looks like an interesting
mod. Once you set it, don't play with it, because then, like, once you leave and then come back, you know, if you keep moving it around, it'll just keep defaulting back to the original. Something like that.
Wait, how it resets when you leave the lot?
Like she was saying, or he was saying in the instructions, like, once you set the lights, don't keep changing them, or it'll keep, like, defaulting back to the original.
Oh, if you move them around or something like that.
Yeah, once you, like say I set the lights or whatever, and then
you move.
I leave my lot or come back, and then if I keep playing with them, it'll just...
Okay, so it resets once in a while. Okay, so I guess it needs fixing.
Yeah,
but
they say it in there. So most of these will tell you stuff like that. So you just read the description. But yeah, but it's nice. So everything will be brighter. Which is good because
I know.
Oh, no.
I know.
Jan is just contemplating something very heavily right now. And he's learned ventriloquism and is talking without his lips moving.
I know.
Follow him. Quickly. Let's make a thumbnail.
Oh. Wait, my eyes... I have glasses, though.
Well, how are his hands? I'm more like... Actually, it's the other way. Oh, there we go.
But I'm always backwards. Wait, it would be like this to me.
Oh, we totally got this week's thumbnail. Now it's basically whatever Jan ends up looking like.
Yeah. But so it was nice though, because last week was the one where I did the mod manager and I did it. So what it did was, I was so confused for the first part of it. I was like, what the heck? Basically, you have to tweak it just right. It adds the folders that you make in the mods in the mod manager folder and then copies everything over to your Sims 4 mods folder, right? Mm-hmm. So it's all legit. But if you don't do it right, it'll just make all these extra copies. I kept like, why is it making all these? Why is it not moving? It's just making all these. You basically, what I had to do was I had to literally move them myself in the folder. And then the mod manager would like reflect it. If I tried to move them in the mod manager, it would just keep making copies and copies and copies and copies.
Man, I guess that wasn't intended. Well, I guess they had to fix it. I'm eating.
Yeah, we saw you, Pablo. You were trying to sneak your food down here.
Oh, it's always a meeting. I shouldn't talk when I'm eating, but whatever.
I wouldn't miss this time. But yeah, so I missed my window of opportunity. Yeah, so I figured out a way to fix it. I mean, not fix it. It probably wasn't supposed to be. I'm just stupid. And it takes me longer to figure out.
That's all right. All right.
Hey,
so
I put my whole computer together myself.
Nice.
I think it just might take an extra couple of minutes for me to figure out stuff like mod manager.
Oh well.
Pablo, Christmas present. Give me money so I can buy my solid state drive for my computer.
I need to get like 70 people here to get enough money.
Just send me like $100, an American.
I'll send you 100 peso. You can buy some candy.
A candy bar, thanks.
That's like $7. You're gonna sell.
You can buy me candy bars for Christmas too. It's okay. I like chocolate.
Oh no, it's
Pablo.
Not seven.
Oh, sorry, Jan. What have you been thinking about this whole time?
Oh, you know, men.
You should just make.
It's the whole boob conversation.
In the Sims game and. I'm pretty sure there are Sim genitalias. There are Sim genitalias for you to download, Jan, if you really want, in your Sims 4 game that you haven't played yet. And then take the mosaic, the sensor off, and there you go.
Sounds awesome.
A mini porn for Jan.
Oh, man.
I don't want to ever download any of that Sims genitalia. Not even for girls. That's just wrong.
Oh, man. No, that's...
I don't even
like
want to talk about
dolls.
They are dolls. They're dolls.
Yeah, and then you just make it creep.
Granted, I mean, I probably have said this before, but I did succumb and I did download genitalia, I think for Sims 1, because I wanted to see what it looked like. And it was just so awkward. So awkward.
Mods, they can do anything you can think of. And stuff you can't think of as well.
I would permit, like, downloading nipples to give your Sims nipples, but not below the belt. I don't want to see you below the belt.
That kind of makes sense. They should make a mod about that. Then we sell the mouse pads. Because, you know, it's going to be, like,
I don't think
hot
we
topic.
Should we be showing pictures of nipples on Naked Sims on the podcast, Papa?
Oh, no. I think you are going to end up being banned on YouTube.
Oh, wait, no, just tag it explicit.
Oh, you can?
Radar.
Can you show that kind of stuff in YouTube? Nobody knows. Well, because you never see that, so I'm assuming you know, they don't let people.
I never look for anything explicit.
You know how, like, usually you see, like, you know, I don't know, top 10 vines of whatever, and it's always, like, a girl with huge boobs in the thumbnail. And, but it's never naked, it's covered, you know. So, I mean, that would even get even more views.
Explicit.
Yeah. But maybe then it wouldn't show, normally?
I'm typing in the word explicit.
You have to activate
YouTube.
It? I don't know what we're looking to. we're past the structure part, so yeah, whatever.
No more.
But,
I don't know. Well, like, I'm sure, like people who do YouTube for music videos, you can listen to the not bleeped out versions.
Right.
So those are labeled explicit, but I don't think there's going to be like porn.
That would be too much on YouTube.
No, I'm sure you can't have porn on YouTube.
10 top 10 controversial movies explicit. Warning, explicit content. These films were lightning rods for scandal.
Yeah, but I think they're thinking more of explicit content in the sign of
vagina.
Not boobies, but you know.
No way, really?
Here's a Faces of Love, 18 plus explicit video. This looks like they're having snooki.
Kids, we don't know when you're looking into this kind of stuff. Aunt Fallon is Logan.
I think it looks like there's porn, so I just tag it explicit, Pablo. We can show some nipples on some game characters.
Yeah, I just showed game pads. That's as far as I'm going on the podcast.
But already explicit, it's too late.
Boobs are explicit. Yay! How much longer do we have now? Yeah. 30 minutes?
Oh, 30 minutes.
Oh, we have like 25 minutes. Yeah, we have like, we did everything like this. We're like German people.
Hey, so what's today? Today is the 24th. So next week, guys, is the December patch, though, actually, you know, because Tuesday is December 2nd and Wednesday is December 3rd. So we're either going to get it next Tuesday or next Wednesday. It'll be December 1st when we do it, so we won't have, anything to talk about.
Of course,
we should make
always.
That one a Thursday one. We should do a Thursday one, so that way we can...
No way. I mean, we will have to, like, move all of them. We still have to figure it out if we just want to move it. Although, I don't know if, like, it's cool to have the podcast on Friday. I think I like
early
Tuesday.
Enough, how long does it take you to render? If you do it early enough, can't you just render it the same day?
I can make it from one day to another, but not within the same day. What's that teddy bear?
They're
cookies.
That's cute.
You
it looks like a teddy bear. But is it yummy? Is it good?
They're different flavors. Think of like graham crackers, but they're little tiny bears.
Oh, look at this thing.
I just bit his head off.
Oh, Jan imploded.
Oh, no.
Yeah, but whenever you do that, like, Fallon starts to cut in pieces on the screen.
I know, that's why I did it.
I'm sitting over here, haha.
No, that's actually worse right now. Because she's still here. You can just still stand fine for now. It's going to be all right.
I was going to say something and I forgot. Oh, yeah. You need the whole day. You can't, like, do it and then show it in the same day.
Oh, no, I cannot do it in, like, just one day. That would be impossible.
Because Pablo's internet is shit.
Yes.
You should send me the video.
I'm in fourth world.
You should fix the video with all the fancy stuff and then send it to me and then I'll upload it for you.
No, yeah, that's the longest process. Just like...
Anyway. No, I think you
I guess meanwhile
email.
I can show... let's see. Just to show something meanwhile. I got the... gameplay of the last SimCity City Rescue that I made, where I find abandoned cities and I reclaim them and I fix them. And in this city, actually, I thought that didn't really have much going on. And then, like, it all started to fall apart. Like, as I was playing it, it was quite sad. I did stop the video a few times just to, like, make quick progress in between. So you didn't have to see the whole thing. And I could just make one episode. Yeah. Otherwise, it would have been, like, an hour-long episode. It ended up being, like, half hour. So, you know. But, just, like, teasing right here.
Huh? I've tried to make my legacy plays like 2 minutes shorter.
Nice.
Although it's the intro and the outro that really like make it.
Right. That extra like 10 minutes. It's all
and
the
I
outro.
I haven't been uploading any videos lately.
It's okay. I saw you put your clothes on.
Oh, she saw the intro on of your videos in your channel.
Oh, she saw the intro. Okay.
Yes. I insist I love that intro. By the way, if no one has ever seen the link to his channel, Jan's channel, it's in the description below. And the intro is pretty cool. I like it. It's exactly what you see right now here on the stream.
Jan's throat. Look at his throat
and
his Adam's apple.
From the from the shoot we did.
Right.
For that video.
Yeah, that was a really nice.
Because that video was used as an intro to a short film.
Oh, yeah? Oh, nice.
Cool.
Well,
but that's you, right?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Oh, and I wanted to ask you as well, what's the image on the top of your YouTube channel? What's that?
I think that's IBM at some point, from like the 80s.
Oh, I see.
I just needed a really color cool photo, and that seemed like a good color photo.
Yeah, it actually made sense.
You know, I have a lovely design for the channel with shit content.
Oh, but you do get views. I mean, people seem to like it.
Them.
You're going to have Pablo guest appear on your channel.
I actually have time to record videos and upload them.
Mm-hmm.
Which I promise I will do more of.
Oh no, Brian is kicking in. Sorry, what?
What?
I will record a bunch of videos tomorrow and upload them. It's just been a busy few weeks.
Yeah, I feel, Actually, I couldn't record any SimCity video for last week. I did for this one, yay.
I barely have time to do this podcast anymore.
I know.
Especially at me.
He wants to leave us. No.
What?
Think of our children.
What happens when you bring in street rats and then they want to leave you? No, just kidding.
Damn.
You're bound by the blood oath that you took when you were passed out and we cut your finger.
Oh, yeah. You're in the podcast.
Oh, yes, I want to thank you for cutting off my sixth finger. It was quite disgusting.
Sixth.
Now I have a lovely five.
Hey, you're normal.
Pablo, I didn't know you cut off any fingers. I just saw the pricking, and then I was like, blood? No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, yeah, it's part of the simulation process of getting into the stuff. You know? We don't ask anything, just a finger. we want you to just thumbs up. So we can cut it. So then we can access your iPhones with, your Touch ID. Touch ID, is it? Yeah, Touch ID.
My phone does that too. You stick your finger on here, and it's like a fingerprint. It still has to be alive.
Oh yeah,
it does. It has to be alive.
On the iPhone, it's on the button.
Have you tried to use a dead finger to see if it worked?
You should, right? As long as it's still kind of moist.
We have been told it doesn't.
Well, I think they want you to think so, but
you can make a fingerprint and then stick it like on that silicone skin on top of your finger, right? And then
I don't know,
like some James Bond kind of stuff.
All to access.
I have really long thumbs.
All
so you might
to
not
access those Pablo's naked selfies.
Oh no! Too bad my phone doesn't have Touch ID. It was on the next one. This is the 5.
Oh, so we can see all of the naked selfies without needing to.
Well, I would have to take those pictures first, but sure.
Apparently, you take them for yawn, you dirty, dirty boy.
What?
We shouldn't talk about this for 20 minutes.
Yes. Like. this is where all the bums in the city, I see them. It's funny because by rescuing these cities, I go through things I never go through because some of them make like really bad decisions out of nowhere. I don't know why. So like I never saw bombs in my cities before, and now I see a bunch of homeless just, you know, spreading through the city. I destroy a park and they rush like rats all over the city to hide somewhere else in abandoned buildings. And
why would you destroy a park?
Well, because I need to move things around because the city has a poor layout. But it's funny because you go through things in the game you otherwise wouldn't if you're so perfectionist, that, like, you do everything right from the start. So I think it's a nice change.
One of the things I hated they put in the game is the zombie apocalypse.
Oh, yeah. I remember in the beginning where, you know, disasters were so often. I got that all the time. I haven't gotten it ever since, but yeah, that's so silly.
I kept looking at it going, really? Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, that had to be completely optional. But I don't know. Like,
you need to
I guess
be prepared
people.
For
it's
the
funny
zombie
because people.
Apocalypse in games.
Yeah. But people remember SimCity because of disasters for some reason. Like, you talk to people and they tell you, oh yeah, I love to destroy my cities. Like, seriously, that is the thing you remember from SimCity 3000 or 4. And now you see on the City Skylines forum people asking for disasters. And I'm like, that's not really important. Like, look at all the work they have been doing so far. I just want a good economic system, a good education system, a good transportation system, and I'll be happy. Right, and a good building tools for making a good city, right? To be able to control it, define it, shape it. But, you know, disaster is not really a priority, if you ask me.
You want a perfect world.
Disasters are interesting. I guess they are interesting. But it's just, I would wish they figured out something slightly more original than the one that's been used everywhere all the time for the past
Giant lizard.
They could be like, I don't know.
We always had Godzilla in SimCity. Well,
yeah. Which is
Godzilla,
funny. They had to change the original cover of SimCity, for those who didn't know, that little like TV box, like looked like an old radio. And it used to have like a city and a Godzilla behind. And they got sued for that because it resembled Godzilla. So they had to change it to a tornado. So there are two different versions of the SimCity, you know, box. At least the art, because sure, they made the unlimited editions, yada, yada, yada. But that is really interesting. But they kept keeping that in all the games. They just call it like Giant Lizard, and that's it. But yeah, it's clearly Godzilla.
I mean, I wouldn't mind if they, instead of the zombie apocalypse, picked something like
a monster.
I don't know, huge superstorm or something. It's just,
you know what? I would love to see more natural disasters.
Yeah.
That would be the thing, because natural disaster, like a tornado is a natural disaster, right? Giant lizard, no, it sounds fun, but you know, I would love to have like, yeah, that, like, you know, a hurricane or like a very tough, a storm, if you may, like you were saying, flood. The SimCity 2000 had flood. That was the only game that had it. So yeah, stuff like that would be like, because those are stuff that happen and then you have to deal with. It'd be cool if you could even prepare for it. Yeah. But wouldn't it be cool if you could prepare for it?
It's fun to have every now and then, you know, to have those weird things like the aliens and the giant lizard. Mm. It's more of a fun thing, but I would love to see more actual natural disasters, because the only one is a tornado and the lightning, isn't it? The lightning is the one as well.
Meteor, you can have meteor on SimCity 4 and the new one. Lightning only on the SimCity 4. Earthquake, you had it on both of them. Tornado, I think, yeah, both of them. Then Giant Lizard, I'm not sure. Oh, on SimCity 4 it was a robot, I think. It was a big robot. Which was also reintroduced in SimCity Cities of Tomorrow as an additional disaster. But again, flood, no there.
Should be like the Power Rangers coming and fighting and blowing your city up.
You did not get our point.
Clearly, though, I mean, have you ever watched the Power Rangers? They destroy the half the city themselves.
Well, maybe if you want, you could just have like a disaster that is like a big heroes fight on the city. So they're like smashing each other against buildings and all the buildings falling apart. Like two Supermans fighting each other, right? The superhero and supervillain and just like bam, bam, and just destroying everything. If you want that, I mean, sure. I guess you could do that.
No,
it is quite entertaining. It's quite entertaining how superheroes usually destroy more of the city than the villains do.
Yeah, like, just let them rob it. No, I don't. They're just taking, like, I know, 500,000, but they're not destroying half city.
Especially with the Power Rangers. The Power Rangers were really shit at keeping the city alive.
Yes. Yeah, which I like to add, did you know that was actually a Japanese show?
Yeah.
I think I mentioned it before in the podcast, but Jan wasn't there.
Yeah, they have a Japanese Power Ranger.
No, like the Power Rangers are Japanese. Whenever you don't see them with the helmets on, it are American actors. And like all the side story or the setup was American actors. And whenever they had the helmets on and the huge things were actually toys.
I mean, those were Japanese shows. Yes, the original Power Rangers did most of their own fighting.
The fighting was Japanese.
No, no, the original Power Rangers, because it did not
yes,
have
the yellow
such
one
a
was a guy. Check her junk. She had junk.
What?
Check it. Yes, because the yellow one made it like a Chinese girl. Why? Because yellow. That was super racist, by the way. Red was like an Indian one. The black was,
no,
oh, surprise, a white guy?
Was
no, a black
was
one.
A regular Caucasian. Pink was a Caucasian. Blue was a Caucasian.
Was
yellow
a girl.
Was Asian. And black was African American. No, the original ones, though, they did most of their own stunt work because they didn't have the budget to hire people to
no,
do the fighting.
No, it was the other way around. They didn't
later
have the budget,
when,
so they bought existing videos from this Super Saiyan
later
genre.
On, then they had
trust
more
me,
budget to hire people. Like all the actors,
trust
like,
me,
they
girl.
Knew martial arts. The actor.
That sounds more expensive than just buying a cheap show from Japan.
No,
just,
because
oh,
it's
we need to fight.
The same
yes, we
actor
do.
Can do their scenes and having to hire two actors, one to be the no helmet and one to be doing
no,
the
No, you don't get it. They bought the finished product of Japan. The fighting was already recorded years ago. They just made the acting for the American people. So it wasn't a Japanese show. But only when they didn't have the helmets on. Whenever they had the helmets on, that's it. You're not going to tell. You're like 7-year-old kid. I'm just going to put that old show there. Look it up. Look it up on Wikipedia.
I did look it up before. And the original
no.
actors did the Power Rangers do
Japan.
Their
I don't know how to look it up. But
stunts.
Yeah, but maybe for like one scene without helmet. The whole, the true fighting part, that's Japanese. That's why they kept
Power
changing.
Power Rangers programs consist of scenes featuring English-speaking actors, either from the United States, blah, 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 spliced with scenes featuring either Japanese actors dubbed into English or the action scenes from the Super Sentai series featuring the Rangers fighting monsters or the giant robot battles with English dubbing.
Super Sentai, not Super Saiyan.
But they still did some of their own stunts.
Maybe once, but...
Some of them, yeah, but apparently the original one was like that. That it was just spliced together with the original show.
I used to think that show was so cool, and now I look at it about, I'm like, this is the cheapest production ever, and it makes millions. It's been off like just like a bunch of things. But that is why like on every season they would change, because they would only make like one season in Japan, right? So they had to buy a different one that also had like colors and big monster and so on, but it wasn't exactly like the same, right? So that's why like every time they had like different people and the fights were different, the shots were different. Like why? No, it was because it was a different show. They were like just putting American actors on top. But the guy is like really
long
clever. Like
this show go for 3 seasons.
Power
Which
Rangers?
One? No, it's still on.
The Japanese one? The Power Rangers is going on forever. It just gets
oh,
weirder,
no, wait,
though.
There's so many different versions of it.
Those are the seasons. Those are the different shows they bought from Japan.
The
for each season?
Power Rangers Megaforce.
Right?
They had ones where they were, the original ones, they were dinosaurs, then they turned into, like, ninjas, and they turned into, like, time travelers, they turned into space people, they turned into all kinds of stuff.
Oh, wait, no, now it's Super Mega Force. And then the one that comes out
oh, Super Mega Force.
Power Rangers Dino Charge.
Jungle Fury. Power
Dino
Rangers.
Charge.
Jungle Fury.
Here I got the Super Megaforce picture. And we got a black, a pink, a green, a red, a blue, and a yellow. It's funny, they all use colors, right?
Yeah.
That's very convenient. That guy's a visionary.
I remember watching this when I was a kid.
Yeah. Me too.
Yeah, I only watched like the first couple seasons because...
The games.
After that, I was like
Nintendo.
Old, and I didn't care anymore.
Wait, Megaforce Japan. Let me see if like there's a way to see the Japanese actors, because they're not called the same. But okay, no, I can totally. Oh yeah, I think these are the Japanese actors. Oh no, I think not. This is just fans. or
Alien
not.
Rangers. Oh yeah, they turn into little kids. There was one who was a little kid, and then when he transformed into a Power Ranger, he became a grown-up.
It's just, I don't know. The Power Rangers were something I watched as a kid. It's just, whenever I see them on TV now, I'm still going, I seriously watch that. Like, seriously. Like,
there were the Turbo ones where they were like vehicles.
Oh, yeah.
That's like a ripoff of freaking Transformers. Power Rangers in Space, Power Rangers Lux Galaxy, Lightspeed Rescue, Time Force, Wild Force.
Force.
Ninja Storm.
Just add Force to it.
Dino Thunder. They already had a dinosaur one. Power Rangers SPD.
Another one.
The names Mystic are
Force.
Awesome.
Operation Overdrive, Jungle Fury, RPM. What? Power Rangers RPM. RPMs? Really? All these
RPM and
car-related Power Rangers. That's like RPMs is like what your car
driving.
Power Rangers Samurai. Yeah, then there's Megaforce. And then in 2015, it's going to be Dino Charge. Again, how many times can you use dinosaurs and cars and Jungle Force?
Force. That's the word. Oh, they should make Dino Super Force. Oh,
Dino
the best
Megaforce.
One ever.
Dino Megaforce. RPM Force. No, you can't just keep reusing the same type of power.
You gotta have Mega. That's what makes it
stop.
Awesome.
You need to stop. Yeah, like, it's no longer cool.
But take a look, like how many things. Sorry. How many like awesomeness words, if you may. This thing has not awesome, like it is actually awesome, but it's loading the picture. Great. It's power, like, oh, that's awesome already. Rangers, that sounds cool. Super, oh my god, Mega, holy shit, Force, oh yes. Like,
well, the first ones though were the Mighty Morphing Power
Mighty
Rangers.
Morphin. Right?
Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
Oh yes. Oh, I remember
Zordon,
that.
The big floating head. Who would trust a big floating head in a tube, first of all? I'm a big floating head in a tube. You should listen to me. Stop Rita and Lord Zed.
Let me see
who was
if I
like a guy with no skin. That's what he looked like. Freaking Lord Zed was a guy with no skin. It was like all muscly red nastiness.
Oh yes, I got the music on.
Nice.
On here. Oh yeah. It's like cheap metal.
The most common color that does not appear every year is pink, followed by green, black, and white. Civilian clothing often matches ranger color.
I just love this, the production value hope that went into this shot.
You're looking at a footage?
I'm looking at a picture. I put the link in the chat. It's hilarious.
Oh.
Just the production, it screams production value.
Yeah, it's Lord Zed, who looks like a muscly guy with no skin. How the two of those would be married, I don't even know. Look at her hair.
Yeah.
I love that whenever we saw Rita, it always looked like she just went to a thrift shop, bought everything, and put it on.
Oh, but remember, those were the mean people. The evils.
Yeah, I do remember. You could tell
they
were
bad.
Rita Repulsa was dubbed.
Just, yeah, the Power Rangers were something so hilarious.
Oh, this is great. Oh, well, I think that's pretty much for this show because we went past the hour, but it was fine. It was really nice to talk about the power, Mighty Morphin, super awesome, great Mega Force Rangers. And
Jungle Fury Rangers, you forgot Jungle Fury.
I forgot Jungle. We should make like one big name with all the adjectives and nouns they ever used. That'd be awesome. We should craft it. We should make like a good one, well-ordered one.
Mighty, Morphin, Power, Alien, Zeo, Turbo.
Turbo, Space. That's an awesome word as well.
Galaxy, Lightspeed.
Oh, Turbo.
Time Force, Wild, Turbo. Ninja, Dino, Mystic, Jungle, Samurai, Rangers.
Oh my god. That sounds like the best show ever. It only takes like a minute to say the entire name. We're going to be millionaires.
Can you imagine the intro sequence for that show? Because in every intro sequence, you have to say the name of the show like 70 times.
You have to say it 70 times.
Well, I
like
started out as
show,
Dinosaur, but then my Power Rangers, half Dinosaur, half Car. I'm a Samurai Ninja Jungle Fury.
It's like Transformers, but way better.
No. All right, thanks.
Yeah, all right, yeah, that was all. I hope you had fun. Next week we're going to be like on every Tuesday. You can also find us on iTunes. Just look
Send
for the Sim Nation podcast. Send her some cookies. Don't forget about that. You can also check us on our website, simnation.tv, and also find Discuss, our forums, where we could just discuss Sim stuff. Go ahead and join us there, and also our at SimNationTV, our Twitter. You can find Chan's channel with that beautiful picture on the description below, as well as Fallon's
it's
top five
Jan.
Mods. Jan, what did I say?
Apple.
Did I say Jan?
Jan. I am
Jan.
Not a woman.
I said Jan. Jan's I am sure I'm Apple. Gonna look that up or edit it if I didn't. And yeah, that was all. That was Fallon right there waving. That is Jan there waving as well. Trust me on that. And that's Pablo also waving. And we'll see you next time.
Oh, this is the most satisfying thing ever. We are God. In SimCity 4. Wow, that was loud.
Oh, you're gonna eat that, huh? You're gonna eat it. I see. What? Nothing. Okay.
And now she is tossing that salad with her... Stop sticking your finger in your ear! All right, she's tossing the salad with her earwax.
Welcome.
You have them both coming out of your nose like this.
I can't. I just can't.
Yeah. These road trips, man, are killing me. Anyway, let me know whenever we are recording.
Hi, and welcome to another episode of Extended Play. I'm your host. This is Stuart, and that is a fancy sign. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.